I want to welcome you to another episode of How I Animate in Clip Studio Paint. So what we're doing today is a viewer requested video. A viewer requested me to do a video on how to import multiple clips into Adobe Premiere. So I want to keep this simple. So I have an old bouncing ball video animation that I did some time ago. And what I wanted to do is just cut this up into multiple clips and then import it into Adobe Premiere. So there's two ways to go about exporting the animation out of Clip Studio Paint. That's with the background and without the background. So I'm gonna show both. Now I have this already cut up into three different clips so we can export three different files. So we wanna shorten the timeline, make sure it's for to the end of that clip, which is connected to the rest of the clips. I just wanna show you the whole bouncing ball thing. Okay, so I'll take the timeline, move it over, and we're gonna just do it normal first. The basic way, which is straight to movie, and that's going to be an MP4, and I'm just going to call it ball one. I'm going to export that out, and it does not matter the size of the canvas, because when you go into Premiere, it's going to do the same exact thing. Whatever the size of the canvas is, that's what you're going to make the sequence into. So let me do these last two, and then we'll move on to the next one. Okay, let's move on to a more challenging way to export a animation file out of Clip Studio Paint. I've done previous videos on this. I would direct you to those, but this is a longer form so we can get into Premiere Pro. So we're gonna get rid of the background, and we're gonna come over to File, Export, and we're going to do image sequence. You want to name your image sequence. We're going to go ball one, and then we want to pick the file that you're going to put it in. We're just going to put it in this random one. Actually, you know what, it's best if you make a folder, so I'll make a new folder, and we're going to call this new folder ball one also. All right, export it out. Let's let it do its thing. We're gonna do the same thing, adjust the timelines on the next two clips, and then move on to Adobe Premiere. So I'll go ahead and fast forward through this since you already know how to export it, and we're gonna move on to Adobe Premiere. All right, so now that we got all of those clips out of Clip Studio Paint, let's bring those clips in. We're gonna start off now with the MP4 though. So we're gonna right click on our project file and just import. We're gonna go find our files. All right, all three of these are MP4s, so they will have the background with them. And open, and now all three of them are in our project. So now let's go ahead and bring in the animations through image sequencing. So we're gonna do the same thing, right click, import. We're gonna go find our folder, and we're gonna click on one of them and then hit image sequence. And it will bring in all the images in that folder into Adobe Premiere. So let's bring in the other three. Import. We're gonna go out, go to the next file. Image sequence is already checked. That's the next one. One more. And let's make sure it's checked. There we go. So let's create an image sequence out of the first three, which are MP4. I'm gonna right click, new image sequence, new sequence from clips. Now, seeing that this sequence is made from the clips themselves, the ratio is going to automatically adjust to the ratio of the clips. So now we should be able to play these three clips together. Boom. So those are these three clips, all put together that easy, because they automatically go into the order that they were imported in. So now let's go ahead and do the same thing with the image sequence clips. I'm going to select all three of them. And we're going to do the same thing. New sequence from clips. Boom. So these, for some reason, imported backwards. So we just want to put them in the order they're supposed to be. Oops. All right. Stack them up. All right. So now we should be able to play these, right? But you can't see it because there's no background and there's no color. So I have to put a white background. So this is called a color mat. And I will make it white. Call it white. And drag it over into the sequence behind these animations that we created. So now I should be able to play it and see our animation. So see? And once again. And that's it. Now, it looks like it's a little bit faster. So I am going to do something to adjust the speed. So I'm gonna bring it down to 50%. And then drag these out a little bit. This is the easiest way to go about doing it. Now, if you need more like detail and all of that stuff, you can put those layers on top or behind, just like I did the background. Everything else is up to you. I think that's enough for this video. If you learned something, please share this video with some of your friends. Maybe they'll help them out. But until next time, as always, anime life forever.
I'm telling my mom.